Hi everyone and welcome back. So sometimes there are questions from array prototype methods also, because they will ask you simple array.prototype.foreach and map, what is the difference? Okay, array filter or reduce, array.map, array.reverse, push, pop, sift, unsift, what all different methods do and when to use what, right? Every method has its own usage. You can't just use sift, unsift with push, pop. Push has its own implementation, concat has its own implementation. So what all different methods are like? So there is a for each method and there is a map method. Okay, so what is the use of for each and what is the use of map? What it does? So from the definition, map takes a callback, for each also takes a callback. For each is primarily used for iterating to an array so that you can, if you want to do some operation on array elements, you can do. It doesn't return any new array, it is used for simple for loop. Earlier we were writing for loop, now we are writing for each loop. Okay, it just takes a callback function. In the callback you can access the value, index and an array. So it has three arguments and these are important because sometimes people get confused. Value is the item, index is the counter, and the array is the array on which you are iterating. Similarly, map always returns a new array. You can actually use map to manipulate the current array, manipulate the values in the current array and return the new array without modifying the existing array, something like this. So here you will get the item, you will get the index, you will get the array also. And here you can actually do what you can do whatever you want, like you get the element. So you want to have every array element incremented by 10. It will return you the new array which you can assign to X. Okay, similarly there can be like map implementation on an object. There will be a complex nested object has been given to you and now you just have to just iterate and do the filtering. So that we have a map, filter, all these methods to do all these kind of jobs. Okay, so map implementation on an object, like simple, you have been given a simple object. This object can be as complex as you want. This is the object array and you can return, you can write a map method on top of it. So map will return the product ID. So here I just want the product IDs in an array, so it will just return 0, 1. Similarly, you can just get the name, so it will give us the product names array, right? So similarly, map filters are actually can be used to do a manipulations and return the new data. It's like used for mostly immutable operations where you don't want to change the existing array. And here you can do a manipulation. You can return whatever you want. Okay, I wanted to return something else. Data equal to test. So it will return a new object having all these properties. ID equal to item dot ID. Plus one, something like this. Okay, so simply adding this map filter on array is very simple. We have just a callback method. Filter can be used to actually filter the condition. It will return, it will not modify the array. It will only update the array and return the, it will just return a true and false, like data dot, sorry, we have item.id, if that is greater than 0, if that is greater than 0, so here we have 1, so it will return that array only based on particular condition. Okay, so this is about array map. We can also talk about the reduce implementation. So we have person array and here I wanted to, so reduce function as the accumulator and the execution block. So this is the accumulator and this is the initializer. So I initialize this with empty object and what I'm doing is, in this accumulator I have this person object dot tags. So I'm just collecting the tags and I'm assigning these tags in the accumulator with value 1. So I just keep assigning that value and I'm returning the accumulator. So accumulator is an object. Okay, so in the above, accumulator is initialized to be an empty object and within the reduce function I'm assigning each tag the key that object is corresponding value will be 1. Okay, so reduce function will always return a single output. Here it is, this is the initializer. and this is accumulator. So we always return accumulator. Accumulator will keep holding the values or keep updating its own object and will return in the log. Okay, so some other methods, like you can also talk about sort method, some find index, includes. These are all important methods which can be asked, well, like what is the difference between find and find index, right? So what find does and what find index does, you can identify that from the difference. So find, if we talk about simple find and find index, I will just, so find find index will just give you the index of the item, or it will return -1. Includes is another one, like you can actually do array dot prototype dot includes. So this includes method will just check a particular item exists in array or not, and it will return true or false. So if you have a choice of find index or includes and all, we choose includes because it will check, it will return true and false. You don't need to worry about value or -1. So find index returns the index of the item you are looking for, or -1 if you are not able to find the corresponding value of it. Every method actually this is used to satisfy a particular condition. If each and every index of array is satisfying the condition, then you can use every, or you can use sum. Sum means even some of the items are satisfying this condition, so it will return true in this case. If we just convert this to every, it means each and every item should satisfy this condition. For this logic, it will return item greater than 1, it will return false. It will just check the criteria, then it will return the boolean, not another array or something. Okay, so these are important methods. The important methods is reduce, for each, and map and filter. Okay, and how we deal with the array, like you can also talk about array.sort, which actually do the sorting. But if you want to have a custom logic like ascending descending order, then you can actually decide A minus B, or you can also do it for the customization B minus A. It will do the sorting of the numbers. Okay, thanks everyone. This is all about array helper methods and the related questions.